Hello everyone and welcome to GeeksforGeeks. Today the problem which we are going to see is to find maximum length Bitonic subarray. Let's see what this problem is all about. So in this problem you will be given an array which will have basically n integers, and the n integers will be the n positive integers, and you have to find a Bitonic subarray. So what do we mean by that? So we say an array I to j as Bitonic if there is a k where I is smaller than or equal to k, which is smaller than or equal to j, such that this condition holds true. Now let's look at what do we mean by this condition. So you have an array element at index k here, then you have an element at index I here, and an element at index j here. So you see that the when you go in this direction, you see that the elements are increasing. So element at index I plus 1 is greater than or equal to element at index I. Then the elements keep on increasing or they remain the same till you come to element at index k. So till this point, the elements are either increasing or they are same. Now after this element at index k, the elements start to either decrease or they remain the same. So if they are same, we are taking care of that by the equal to sign here. Otherwise, they are basically, the next element is basically smaller than the previous element. Here the next element was basically greater than the previous element. So we have an we have to find an array basically which firstly increases to a maximum value and then starts to decrease. So there could be multiple such subarrays in an given array. So we have to find the maximum length of such a subarray. Okay, so we have to write a function that takes an array as an argument and returns the length of the maximum length subtonic array. Okay, so the expected time complexity of the solution is order of n. Okay, so let's see how we are going to do it. So first of all, let's look at a few examples. So we are given this array. Okay, so the maximum length for the Bitonic array is basically 5 for the 4, 78, 90, 45, and 23. So you see, starting from the element 4, the values start to increase, 78 and 90. After the value 90, the elements start to decrease their value. So 45 is smaller than 90, then 23 is smaller than 45. So this is the maximum length of the Bitonic array. Okay, so let's, after we are done with the first example, let's go to the second example here. So you are given this array now. So the maximum length is again 5. So let's see for which subarray we are talking about. So the array subarray starts at 1, then 2, then 3, then 4. So the elements were increasing till this point. Now it decreases. So 2. Now 10 is greater than 2, so we'll not include that. And 4 was also greater than 1, so we'll not include 4. So this is the Bitonic array, and the maximum length will be again 5. Okay, so let's look at the solution. So we'll first of all look at the solution by using an example, and then we'll dive into the code. So for this solution, what we are going to do is we are basically going to consider this array to get to the solution. So in this solution, we are basically going to use two auxiliary arrays, which will be INC inc, which stands for the increasing, and DEC dic for the decreasing. So you construct an auxiliary array from left to right, such that the value at index I contains the length of non-decreasing subarrays ending at index I of the array. So if because we are given this array, so we have to find the non-decreasing subarrays ending at index I. So non-decreasing means increasing basically. So starting from the element 12, so the value will be 1 because we have just one element here. Now we come to 4. Now 12 is greater than 4. So again, the value at index 1 will be again 1. Then we process 78. Now the value will be 2 here because we are now having an increasing sequence here. 4 then 78. Now we come to this 90 value here. So the length of the non-decreasing subarray ending at 90 is now 3. So we put 3 here. Then we come to 45, which is actually decreasing. So we put 1. Then we come to 23. Again, its value decreased. So we place here 1. So we have our first auxiliary array ready. Now let's construct the second auxiliary array. In this array, we'll be constructing this array basically from right to left. So it contains the length of the non-decreasing subarrays starting from element at index I. So when you're checking here, so you are start checking the elements. We are basically looking for the array from the right side. Okay, so we start processing 23. So 23, we have just processed one element, so the value will be 1. Then we come to 45. Now it's increasing. 23, then 45. So we place 2 here. Now we encounter 90, again it increased, so we place 3 here. Then 78, the value decreased, so we place a 1 here. Then we come to 4, the value again decreased, we place a 1 here. Then we can encounter 12, so 4 and 12 forms a sequence, so increasing sequence, so we place 2 here. So we are done with both the auxiliary arrays. Now once we have both the arrays, what we need to do is we need to find the maximum value of basically this expression, which is element and index I of the first auxiliary array plus the element and index I of the second auxiliary array minus 1. We do a minus 1 because the same element would have been counted in both of the arrays, so we do a minus 1. So we basically compare the sum minus 1. So 1 here plus 2 minus 1 becomes 2. So that is the maximum value till now. Then 1 plus 1 minus 1, that is 1. Now we have encountered a value 2 here. So then 2 plus 1 minus 1, that is again 2, that is the same value. 3 plus 3 minus 1, that will be 5. Okay, that's a maximum value now. So 3 plus 3 minus 1 is 5. Now 1 plus 2 minus 1 and 1 plus 1 minus 1. So 5 is the maximum value for this expression. And that is basically our solution for the index I equal to 3. Okay, so let's look at the code for to achieve this solution. So we have the driver method here where we are taking where we are declaring basically the array and we calculate its size. Then we are printing the maximum length Bitonic subarray as this. We call this function Bitonic here, and let's see. So we come here. So this is the whole crux of our algorithm. So we declare our two auxiliary arrays. Both will be of size n, where n is the size of the array. Then we have some variables int I and max. Now we initialize the element at index 0 of the increasing array as 1 and the last value of the decreasing as 1. So we do that because when we encounter these arrays, so because we'll be using the previous value in this case and the next value in this case, so we have to have the initial values because this is the first elements which we are going to encounter in these two loops. Okay, so now we have placed the value at index 0, so we start the loop at 1 and we traverse the array. Then we decide on the value of the index at element I, basically the value at index I by comparing the value at index I with the value at index I minus 1. If the value at index I is greater than the value at index I minus 1, then we put the value inside the inc array as inc I minus 1 plus 1. So we increment the value by 1 for the previous element. So if the previous element has the value 1, so now this value becomes 2. If it has the value 2, it becomes 3. Otherwise, it means that the previous element was bigger actually. So the maximum length of the increasing subarray ending at index I will be 1. So we place 1. Similarly, now here we have already placed the value at index n minus 1. So we'll start the loop at n minus 2 and we traverse the array. So here we are basically putting the value inside the decreasing array. So we again implement the same logic. So if element at index I is greater than the element at index I plus 1, note that we are now traversing from right to left. So that's how we are comparing it with the index I plus 1. If that is the case, we increment the value of the element at index I plus 1 of the decreasing array. So we increment it by 1. If that is not the case, then we just place the value 1 here, because it means that there is no subarray which is increasing, and that is ending at the index I. So that will include only, so it means that there is only one element, and that is why I place the value 1 here. So after we are done with these steps, then we come here where we are calculating the maximum value. Again, we initialize the value max with index 0 of both the arrays minus 1. Then we run a for loop where we calculate the maximum value for this formula, and in the end we just return the maximum value, and that will be our solution. So the time complexity of this solution will be order of n, and the auxiliary space used is basically these two arrays and few variables. So because of this, the auxiliary space used will be order of n, and the time complexity is again order of n, because we are having these three loops which traverse the array three times. So that is again linear time complexity. So that is the order of n. So that is all for this tutorial. You can visit this link on the GeeksforGeeks website to find out all the stuff which we discussed in this tutorial, and to also run the code which we just discussed. Thank you very much.